Hey everyone, it's Viv here, and I wanted to do a video. I am so excited. I don't get a lot of happy mail, and that's not a request to send more. That's not what I'm trying to say, but I'm just very happy because I don't. And so I appreciate when someone takes the time to give me something and think about me. So here we go. A very dear friend, and she has been a dear friend, Scrapping Crazed, aka Diane, who is a homegirl, has been such a dear, dear, dear person to me through my journey, through a number of things. And her kind words have gotten me through more than she even knows. Has taken the time and sent me something. And I wanted to share it with you. And I also wanted to thank her so very much. And thank you just seems to be an understatement sometimes. And this would be a situation. She put in a lot of hard work in this, and I just want to share this with you. So I received it yesterday, and I'm sharing it with you today. Okay, so let me take out some of the things, and all of these things just made me very, 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 very happy. Okay, well, this is in my hand first, so I'm going to show you, and it says something for you to cut up and use on your projects. It has a little heart on it. Ah! Just love it, love it, love it. Okay, so these are excellent. Now, Diane, I don't know that I would cut them up because they're beautiful. They're absolutely beautiful. I wouldn't do it. I would actually use this. And I have a special place that I'm going to put this at the beach. And when I first saw it, that's what I thought about. So I will not be cutting this up. This is, you know, if I had a hoard vault, it would go in it, but I don't. So it is going to actually be out in plain view where I could see it at the beach. So I'm going to use that there. And this is another item that I will use at the beach. I couldn't cut it up. There's no way I would. It's well done. It's well knitted. And I will be using it at the beach. So thank you so very much for thinking of me and giving this to me. Okay, look how she wrapped this one. This is beautiful. I love this. And I'm taking these out. And oh, wait a minute. This is beautiful. Now this I definitely will use on a project. Love it. I love how intricate these are with the pearls on them. And I have been trying to do some embroidery with pieces, but not knowing how to do the beadwork that goes along with it. So I'm glad that I have this, that I can actually see and maybe replicate this in some other pieces that I've embroidered. Thank you. And then we have some lovely lace. Lace is, oh my goodness, it's a perfect gift. Perfect. This is beautiful. I love the size of it as well. Some plans for this. Plans, plans, plans. Ooh. And this feels like it's starch too. It has a lot of body to it. This is beautiful. And the color, I don't know if you could see the color of this. It's like an antique beige, if you will. Love it. I love the size of these as well. I don't have any lace this size. Thank you so much. The color of this is striking to me. I think this is a very popular color. I'm seeing a lot of things in this color. I love this. This is going to be good on a number of sewing projects as well as paper products or projects. It's almost like a paisley in there as well. Beautiful, beautiful. And she sent a lot of it. This is very generous. Thank you. And last but not least, beautimus, beautimus, beautimus. And this is the shabby chic. These are the colors. I love these colors together. Not to mention this tissue paper. I'm loving that. Okay. Oh my. You see, of course you saw what it said, Diane. This is beautiful. She filled her life with things that made her happiest, which were really things. This is beautiful. Where did you get this, Diane? I want some more. I don't want you to send me any more. I don't mean it that way. I want to buy some more. Okay, this book she made. Oh, wow. I have seen people make lace albums, but of course I don't own one, and this is my first. Thank you again. Look at this, how she decorated and has lace on the outside. And I don't recognize this paper, but it's beautiful. And she has a flower here, a fabric flower. The butterfly is gorgeous. And I don't know flowers. I don't know the names of them. I love these. I'd like to know more about these flowers. And then, ooh, I didn't see this before. There's a piece here. Wow. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. Okay, and on the inside. Now, when I first saw this, these look like spools. So I thought that was very clever. And well, well put together, well designed. And this is beautiful lace that she sent me. And she has a pin in all of them so they won't unravel. Beautimous, beautimous. And I love the colors. And I have not seen these laces before. This is gorgeous. And once again, this is something that I could use on both paper products or projects, as well as sewing or material fabric projects. Look at that. Look at the colors. This is a very pretty peachy color. Oh my word. These are just so intricate. Love them all. I really do. Really, really, really do. Diane, this is so generous of you. And like I said, she didn't just do a little bit. Here you have a... No, these are ample amounts. This, I love this. And once again, I love the size. You get a lot of choices with that. Beautiful, beautiful. This is absolutely incredible. I love it. Love it. Love them all. I can't thank you enough, Diane. I really appreciate it. Once again, it's handmade. Somebody actually thought about me. And all of the laces and whatnot, it's just incredible. Of course, this got my mojo going, and I can't wait to show you some projects that I would do with these particular laces and whatnot. Thanks again, Diane. I am going to write you when I'm finished taping, so you'll probably get my message before you see the video, but please know that I'm very grateful for it all. And she also sent me a card, but I'm not going to share it with you. Well, I could share the actual card with you. And I love them. And I can't wait. I truly hope I can get back to doing the swaps on your paper pantry. I do miss them incredibly. This is gorgeous. I love it. And intricate. And I guess because I have tried to do some of the intricate smaller, I know the work that goes into this. So this is beautiful, and it means so much, and her kind words mean a lot as well. So thank you, Diane. And please go on over to her channel, Scrap and Crazed. And if you're a part of your paper pantry, then you know what a wonderful, wonderful person she is, and organized to actually do the swaps or lead the swaps. So, and if you don't know, please go over and see her work. And maybe you'd like to join your paper pantry and join her swaps. She is absolutely wonderful. Okay, so I know some of you are like, okay, well, we haven't seen you all summer. Well, for the most part, you haven't. And I can't really apologize for that, but because I definitely needed my rest and to gear up for what's getting ready to come up. Monday, the teachers go back to work, so it's pretty much over. I am going to try to go to the beach this weekend and take my beautiful things, as I said, and just one last hurrah before we really, you know, dig our heels in and get to work. What's also interesting, I'm thinking about showing you my journey in decorating my classroom. And I say that because I use a lot of my paper crafting skills and creativity and putting the classroom together. So I'm going to think about that a little bit, because I don't want to get, you know, too much involved with my school and my crafting channel because they're two different things. But I have shared some things about school on my channel, so, and I don't want to be inappropriate with that as well. Okay, so one of the things I also want to share, I want to take this time and share with you, is a new product as I gear up for school. There are a couple of things that I got to get ready for the school year. This is one of them that I've had this summer. Some of you may know it is a Fitbit. And the Fitbit is wonderful. It's not like I'm on this, you know, lose weight or lost weight journey or anything like that. Because as much as I try to, it doesn't work like that. And then I get disappointed and get discouraged. So I decided not to do that, but just be more cognizant, more aware of what I'm putting in my mouth and what I'm doing and not doing. And this has helped greatly. I'm not saying that I lost, ooh, she lost so many pounds. No, that's not what the purpose is. And I had to change my way of thinking there. And it just, and the app is free. So before I even got this, I put the app on my phone and the app is free. So if you're interested in it, I'll talk about it more. I won't bore you with those details right now, but it's very interesting. So this is one of the things that I got into was the Fitbit. And the other thing, as I get ready to go back to school, that I got into was the smart pen. Now the smart pen is not new. There have been several different versions of this, but I came in on LiveScribe 3, and there are a lot of videos on YouTube about it as well. But it's a smart pen because it uses special paper, but now you can actually run it off, so you're not committed to buying their actual books. But this is a journal, and I use this to actually write notes on things. And the notes actually go to my iPad or my iPhone where I can work on them in different places. But I have a hard copy already that I wrote. And one of the reasons I did that was because I wanted to actually talk to, now I know I'm dreaming here, might even be a fantasy, but I wanted to talk to the folks at LiveScribe about doing a book, a lesson plan book, a teacher's role book. Where we can keep a hard copy and it can actually go to the program that we use for our school. But it has been absolutely fabulous for taking notes because you're actually writing it down. And if you decide you want to go back to it or if you miss something, you can. I'm not explaining this very well, but for those of you who actually like to write things down, this is wonderful. If there are parts of your notes that you want to send to people or you want to message to people, you can do that by having it on your iPad, your iPhone, anything Mac at this point, I believe. It doesn't have an app for any of the Androids yet. So, you know, that is yet to be seen. But it's a wonderful pen if you want to know more about it. And because I botched up the whole definition and an example of this, so you could look up LiveScribe smart pen on YouTube as well as the Fitbit. Okay, so on to crafty things. Some of the things that I've worked on this summer, I found these lovely Sizzix framelits by Stephanie Bernard, and they are card making dies. And Michael's had a 50% off coupon, or someone had a 50% off coupon, and I used to get these one day at a time. And the draw was that they were A2, and I have an A2 envelope die, and I had gotten Stephanie Bernard's Flip-It dies before, but they wouldn't fit into any envelope that I had or had access to. I would have to actually make them with the envelope board, which isn't a big problem, but it's just a little more convenient, I'll be honest, to do an A2 envelope. So this was a wonderful die. What's very different about these is that they come with an envelope that all the dies go into. But my suggestion, and I'm just suggesting, is that you get a magnetic piece to put them all on because they can sometimes come out of the envelope. Here are the envelopes. This one I hadn't opened yet. And this is the example of the envelope. And if they are moved around, some of the little pieces come out the side. This is another one. This is actually the stand-up version of the Flip It. Okay, and this is the Regal. And then this one is the Regal Flip It. Okay, and these are all framelits. You can once again see. Now, I'm going to tell you the difference in the stand-up one. These come with more dies in it. They're like 22 pieces, and they have the actual word dies in them as well. So this is a very good buy. It's a little bit more, but you get 22. I think the dies are very generous. There's 10 dies in it. And I'm going to give you examples or show you examples of the ones I did with the Regal. Now the difference in the Regal, this is a little different. This is called the Royal, and this one is the Regal. So you can kind of see the difference. I haven't cut anything out of the Royal Flip It yet. Okay, so and there's plenty of room for embellishments and all that kind of good stuff. So I felt real good about it. So I started working on some of the cards, and I wanted to show you some of the cards that I did with them. This was the triple circle one, and I had a bit of a challenge doing these because when you open them, this is a wonderful, you know, seam here. But when you close it, you had this little bit kind of sticking out. So I wasn't all that keen on that. And of course, if it's going to go into an A2 envelope, I had to be very careful about putting embellishments on if it's going to travel or something like that. So I had to be very careful about how much embellishing I did. This was another card. This is the Regal Flip It. And I kind of solved my problem here by putting another label here. So this could be a scene. I would probably, if I had to do it again, use a different color label. And then when you open it, it's another scene as well. Sending happy thoughts. So wonderful, wonderful. I love, love the die. And the embellishments on here are just enough to fit into my A2 envelope. And what's wonderful about this is that the die pieces cut out all of these. And on the back, you can also put different colors and whatnot. So I really did love everything about that. And all the dies that come in it. This one, I love this flower. I love, love, love. And all of my things that I purchased a while ago. I'm doing some downsizing at this point. I'm not doing any destashing as far as online or anything, but I am doing that. I'm getting rid of a lot of stuff. And I'm going to just keep what I am using. And my hope is that, because I had spun out of control. I really had, as far as acquiring things. So as I purchase things, I'm going to be very aware of, you know, am I going to use it right now? And anything left over, okay, I can use that later. But, you know, only buying things for projects that I'm currently working on is my new mantra. I'm not going to buy things for the future, you know, because they pile up and I seem to never get to them. So I'm going to try to buy things currently. And that's sometimes hard to do with the pressures of sales. When there's a sale, you go, well, you know, what, you can't beat it for so much. You know, it's only 25 cents. It's only a dollar. But the bottom line for me is that I'll get it and I'll stash it away somewhere where I can't see it. And it's a vicious cycle for me. So I am going to try to get rid of things that I'm not using or don't intend to use, or I think someone else could use more, and just keep it very simple, and as I need things, buy things. Now that's what I say. We're going to see how far I get with it, you know. We all have good intentions. All right, so this is another one where I used a label to kind of make the scene, and once again, I think I would have used a different color there. And when you open it, it's a wonderful scene. I think I'm praying for you. Okay, and here's some lace on here, but this is not as pretty as the lace I got from Diane. All right, so I'm very eager and excited and inspired to go and create with some of those lovely laces and whatnot that Diane sent. The other thing that I purchased a while ago was some of the Julie Nutting doll stamps. And I was so happy to get the card, the smaller versions of them. And you know what? It was like, I don't know how long, months, before I actually used them. And that just told me right there, I don't need to be getting every release, which seems to be coming a lot quicker than my paychecks. So I'm going to be satisfied with what I have. And I am. I have the first release and I have these card ones. Not all of them, but the ones I have, I'm very happy for. I think I have four different card ones. And that's going to be it for me. And that's not a slap against Julie Nutting and all that. I'm just going to just use what I have and be happy with it. And so I made these tags. And love how you can actually, you know, make a tag card. And that's what I did here. And what I did, Sizzix has this die that makes it an easel. So, and I've seen a few people, so none of this is brand new. I'm not trying to make it sound like, ooh, you just came up with that. No, I know I didn't. But I love that idea of making the card and putting an easel on the back so you can set that, you know, or whoever you give it to. And the thing is, I have the envelope that goes with this tag. So it slips right in the envelope. And then when they get it, they can actually set it up and put it on their desk. So this was some of my trial run kind of cards. And these are watercolor. That was the other thing I played with, was watercolor. So all of these that you see were watercolor. Here's the other one, sending you warm wishes. Watercolor. Had a great time in my journal with watercolor this summer. Wonderful, wonderful, wonderful. So those are the paper products or projects I worked on. And someone did a tag swap where they used different shapes. And while I wasn't in the tag swap, I didn't, you know, feel like I could do a swap at that point. I did have my little kitty cat, which is also an AccuQuilt kind of die. And I cut it out, and on the back it says to and from, and made just for you because you're priceless. I love that stamp. I know a lot of you have that. And then I put some flowers and whatnot on it. And just absolutely fell in love with it. So I kind of just sit this around in different places. And it's wonderful to actually think about different things you can do with different shapes. So that was one of them. Then I'll go into my fabric kind of projects. As you might know, Tilda. I have just a few things of Tilda, but I love Tilda fabric. So I made some tags with my embroidery machine. And I purchased the design for tags and made this. And this is vinyl on the inside, so you can put your information. So this is some Tilda fabric. And this is the back of it. These are very simple to make. And you can put this on your book bag, knapsack, or you can put this on your lunch kit or on your book, you know, your, what's that, computer bag, whatever, you know, you want, or your luggage. And here's one that I made. I just didn't put the ribbon through it. And this was a stamp I have been anxious to use. I love that stamp. Here's my little girl's stamp. And I just put those in because your name and address and all that kind of stuff can actually go on the other side of it. So this is also a Tilda. And this one's not a Tilda. But I love, love, love this fabric. Susan Wingate made this or designed this fabric and also the paper to match. So I love that. This is a Tilda piece. And I have very small pieces of Tilda fabric, so these were perfect for it. This is a quilted piece, and it came quilted. And I love, this was so easy to do. And it's so rich or thick and thirsty of a tag. I love, love, love it. And I put the satin stitch around that one. Not all of them did I do satin stitch. So I really love that one. And this is the Tilda piece as well. Okay, this is a Tilda piece of fabric as well. And then I had some vinyl. And I started doing some really nice things with vinyl. You know, you can get vinyl at Joann's and you can embroider on vinyl. And I took one of the tags that I have and just I sewed two pieces together, and then I put the vinyl around with this stitch. And really, this was actually a trader's card from a Sizzix trader's card die. And then I just took it and went all the way around it. And then I had some pink jute that I put on here. So that's that project. And of course, before you saw my journal that I made, I had a wonderful time. I put the journal inside, and I went all through July. I did so well with writing down for the month of July everything that I ate for different meals, and it was very informative. It really was. And for August, I actually used my Fitbit to enter the information on my telephone. And what's neat about it is that if it has a label, whatever you're eating has a label, you just point to it and it automatically goes on your phone. So I documented so far things that I've eaten in August. And it's telling, you know, I use that as information for myself. So that left this journal cover kind of free. And what I did here, and I wanted to share with you in case anyone's interested, at Barnes & Noble, they have this weekly planner. And it's like an A5, and it fit perfectly into my A5 journal cover. And on here it says Lady's Diary. I thought that was perfect to have. So this is something that I will use at school and get all those dates in at school. Alrighty then. That's it for me. That's what I've been doing, and I just wanted to share these things with you, and also share with you these lovely laces and presents from Diane. And Diane, please know how very grateful I am and thankful I am for your friendship and for your gifts. Have a wonderful day and take care. Bye.